Our video is not recording perfectly. It's a little...
Well, that's okay. I thought we would have to be having an informal chat. The thing that I know, that the nice thing I saw recently that was our last chat about methane, that your colleagues worked up into a pretty nice YouTube, which
I saw good. That had taken off, but I had not had a chance even to watch the content since we recorded it. And I've been with my situation, I've been
yes, yeah. How is it? I mean, what are you having? You said you're having chemo at the moment. Or?
Well, chemo is not something you want to wish on your worst enemy. It's very nasty stuff, obviously. So I went through a round of it about 6 weeks, 2 months ago, and it was horrible. It almost killed me. So I stopped the chemo, went to the Mayo Clinic, exhausted all of their diagnostic tools for the moment. And so I have a cancer which is called an oligometastatic tumor. Which means that, yes, it metastasized, but you only had a small number of metastases as opposed to it went everywhere.
Right.
So my particular cancer does not seem to have an appetite for spreading. So it actually gives me a better shot at overcoming it.
All right. Hope for the best.
Yeah. So that's the deal. So we're doing a different form of, a little bit different chemotherapy, something that's not quite as difficult as the other one that I did. And I seem to be recovering, although I've only had one session of this kind, and next Friday I get my second session, so we'll... So I don't know. Do you want to talk about the shape of the climate that we can maybe carve one or two more programs out of?
Well, the interesting thing about Greenland is it was only 2012 that the first time that the entire surface of the ice sheet was in a melting state, so it was liquid water everywhere. That had never happened before because you only had some melting around the edges. So I'm sure it's happening now again at this moment, because the air temperatures are now up. It's 21 degrees C in Greenland at the moment, which is warmer than England. And so there's going to be massive amounts of surface melt all over the ice sheet. There's a whole new theory about the melt from Greenland, and which... Usually, as soon as you get a new theory, things get worse. And the original idea was, was the surface, you might get melt on the surface in the summer, then it freezes again in the autumn, and that's it. There's no change to the mass. That's obviously been out the window for several years. But the second theory was that the meltwater gathers in... runs towards centres where it melts its way down through a thing called a moulin, and which runs right down to the bottom of the ice sheet, and you get kind of Niagara Falls of water going down to the bottom of the ice sheet. So that is then that water, when it gets to the bottom, spreads out at bedrock level and tends to make outlet glaciers run faster, increases the iceberg flux, but it generally causes an increase in the in the outflow of water, so increases the rate of sea level change. But the new theory, which I think is actually based on observations as well, is that there's a level below the overlying snow, and this happens in winter as well as summer, that you've got the thick snow layer on top. Below that, you have the first level of ice, and the ice actually melts because the snow is acting as a kind of thermal blanket over the top. So you get some melt of the ice, and the meltwater is held in this layer of ice with snow on top of it, and then really frozen ice below it. So you've got a kind of a stratum of soggy water inside the ice sheet, and then that starts heading horizontally off to become a kind of river system and ends up going out to sea. And that also then gets rid of ice or water from the ice sheet into the ocean, and apparently is a more efficient mechanism even than Moulin. So it means that we can expect the rate of loss, the rate of sea level rise to accelerate greater than people suspected from the original theory.
So again, so the difference here is that the water, melt water, is not going all the way to the bedrock and out. It's going out through the sides.
Yes, it's going out sideways and meandering around, forming a kind of river system below the upper layers of the ice.
It's a sort that of actually makes sense. Yeah, is there a name for this theory or the formations?
No, it hasn't. No, because Moulin was the work. I mean, they do exist, because they're very dramatic holes, but there isn't a word for this new theory. It's just out in the last month or so. It makes sense as a model, and I'm not quite sure how you gather the direct evidence. Probably putting markers or dye markers or radioactive markers in the layer just below the snow and seeing where they go. Mm-hmm. But that's further work is necessary.
All righty. Well, good. So we had our informal chat.
Yes. Anyway, I told you what's going on. That's